Dear viewers, welcome to our channel GVS Bank Academy. Today I am going to discuss about priority sector lending. Priority sector lending RBI latest guidelines along with amendments. This topic is very useful for JAB, principle and practice of banking, JAB accountancy also, and for the CIB, advanced bank management, advances module and retail banking fund, and for all the promotional examinations for all skills. Very, very important topic for all the, you can say, very important for the bankers. Now, priority sector lending, or the base circular is RBI master circular, master directions, priority sector lending, targets and classification dated 4th September 2020. This was updated. It was updated up to May 2021. Now, before starting this priority sector targets and sub targets, first you must know the ANBC calculation, ANBC definition. ANBC means adjusted net bank credit. On this figure only the bank's priority sector targets are going to be fixed. That's why before starting the various targets and sub-targets, first we are discussing adjusted net bank credit definition. What is meant by ANBC, adjusted net bank credit? Now, this first. Now, for the calculation of ANBC, first, bank credit in India. If you can take any bank, what are the total advances, credit in India, that only you have to take. It means if the bank is operating outside India, the advances of outside the country is not going to be taken. It means bank's credit or bank credit sanctioned and outstanding in India, that only you have to take. As per bank's balance sheet, bank's credit sanctioned and outstanding in India, that is the. This is as per bank's balance sheet. Plus add one, two, three. These are three factor points you have to add to bank rate India. Number one, outstanding deposits with RIDF, Rural Infrastructure Development Fund, NHB, National Housing Bank, NABARD and SIDBI. Sometimes, because non-achievement of priority sector targets, the banks are depositing the difference amount of the priority sector deficit amount with RIDF, NHB, NABARD and SIDBI. This amount normally decided by RBI where the bank has to deposit. That's why this is amount outstanding deposit under RIDF, NHB, this. Point number two, other investments eligible to be treated as priority sector. Other investments eligible to be treated. It means sometimes the banks are purchasing priority sector advances from other banks. Other investments eligible to be treated as priority sector. Since the banks are purchasing priority sector advances under securitization from other banks, that also will come under priority sector. What are the investments made in securitized assets? That securitized assets belong to priority sector. That amount also can be added to bank credit in India under point number two. Point number three, bonds, debentures in non-SLR categories. Normally, these bonds and debentures are non-SLR categories. Whatever the non-SLR categories which are parked under held to maturity category as per specification of RBI. Sometimes, on the specific instructions of RBI, banks are going to park the non-SLR category of investments under held to maturity category. Such type of investment also you have to add to A, bank credit in India. Then add 1, 2, 3. One is outstanding deposits under RIDF. Other investments eligible to be treated as priority sector. Number three, bonds to debentures in India, SLR in non-SLR securities. The three, 1, 2, 3, we are going to add to A. A plus B, A plus B. A plus B means the three factors, 1, 2, 3. Less. From this bank rate in India, you have to deduct. What is A? Bills discounted with RBI at bank rate. Any times if bank is rediscounting the bills, that bills are going to be deducted from bank rate. That is there. At the time of rediscounting, Reserve Bank is charging bank rate. That is there. B. Eligible amount for exemptions on issuance of long-term bonds for infrastructure and affordable housing. If any bank has issued infrastructure bonds and affordable housing for onward financing, if the period is 7 years and above, that amount also can be deducted from bank rate in India. Number two. Number three, loans. See, loans against FCNR, NRE deposits qualifying for exemption in CRR and SLR in 2013 and 14, a short period, RBI was exempted for CRR and SLR requirements on NRE and FCNR deposits. So during that period, whatever the deposit was opened, presently outstanding, that any loans against given, that also we can deduct. D. Investment made by public sector banks in the recapitalization bonds floated by Government of India. Sometimes Government of India floating recapitalization bonds to help to public sector bonds. So any bank invested in recapitalization bonds floated by Government of India, that amount is also deducted from bank rate in India. Then last find for this C, last find. This is important. Face value of securities acquired. Face value of securities acquired means invested and kept under HTM category, held to maturity category, under the TLTRO. This is the new concept 2020 onwards. Targeted long-term repo operations. If any bank is borrowed under targeted long-term repo operations and invested as per the RBI directives, that investments are allowed to invest in HTM category under TLTRO, targeted long-term repo operation 2, and SLFMF, special liquidity facility for mutual funds. RBI, a specific window was opened during a specific period during the 2020, in that any special liquidity facility provided by banks to mutual funds under this, that amount also can be deducted from this. Now, totally, we had discussed the A and B, C. Now, bank rate in India, that is A plus B. B means 1, 2, 3, A plus B, minus C, A, B, C, D, E. These five points comes under C. This you can deduct C, then you will get adjusted net bank credit. Adjusted net bank credit. Now, in so many examinations, in JAB and CAB, in the promotion examinations, they are asking question on calculation of ANBC, Without knowing this structure, I think it is not possible for. So, the participants have to understand very clearly about the ANBC calculation. If we can know the ANBC bank rate in India, what we have to add and what we have to subtract, we can know, we can do the problem very easily. And you can get, particularly they are asking for 5 marks case study. In CAB, they are asking 5 marks case study. This is about ANBC definition. Now, targets and sub-targets for priority sector have been as per RBI priority sector lending directions. This is there. Now, this is the domestic commercial banks and foreign banks with 20 branches and above. This is the foreign banks with less than 20 branches, regional rural banks and small finance banks. This is the table. Total priority sector target for domestic banks and foreign banks with above 20 branches. 40% of adjusted net bank credit, 40% of adjusted net bank credit or credit equivalent to off balance sheet exposure whichever is higher. This is important. 40% of NBC or create equivalent to off balance sheet exposure, whichever is higher. Higher is very, very important, number one. For foreign banks operating less than 20 branches, for them also, priority sector target is 40%. Out of 40%, they can go up to 32% in the form of lending to exports and remaining 8% in any other priority sector. This is for foreign banks with less than 20 branches. With less than 20 branches. Regional rural banks, their priority sector target is 75%. 75%. Small finance banks also 75%. Small finance banks also 75%. So this is the total priority sector target for domestic banks and foreign banks with above 20, 40%. Less than 20 foreign branches also 40. RRB 75. Small finance banks 75%. Agriculture, 18% of NBC or credit equivalent of balance sheet exposure, whichever is higher, out of 18%, 10% is must for small farmers and marginal farmers. Out of 18% of agriculture, at least 10% must go to small farmers and marginal farmers. Small farmers means 2 hectares. Marginal farmer means 1 hectare land holding. That is there. Small and marginal farmers sub-target for 2021, current year 9%, 2022-23 9.5%, 2023-24 10%. Now they are asking question on this point also. What is the sub-target for small and marginal farmers for 2021-22, 9%, or 2023-24, 10%. So the members have to know this change. This is the latest change in RBI circular. This is the latest change. Foreign banks with less than 20 branches, agriculture target is not applicable. Regional rural banks, same as domestic banks, same as 18% to 18% to 10%. So there is no change in regional rural banks, small finance banks, just like domestic commercial banks and foreign banks with 20 branches. Micro enterprises, this is also sub-target. 7.5% of ANBC or credit equivalent to off-balance sheet exposure, whichever is higher, it will go to micro enterprise. What is meant by micro enterprise? Investment not exceeding 1 crore and turnover not exceeding 5 crores. That is as per latest definition. Micro enterprise means investment to limit 1 crore and turnover not exceeding 5 crores. In the 10 years, bank has to give at least 7.5%. Regional rural banks also 7.5 and small finance bank also applicable to 7.5. This is there. Then advances to weaker sections. Advances to weaker sections. 12% of ANBC adjusted net bank credit or credit equivalent to off balance sheet exposure, whichever is earlier. Earlier this is 10%. Now it is increased to 12% as per September 2020 circular. So that's why this is also very important. For the current year, the target is 11%. For the current year, weaker section target for scheduled commercial banks and foreign banks, 11%. And next year, 22-23, 11.5%. 23-24, 12%. So 12% is by 23-24, 12%. Current year, 11 only, 21-22. So this is the latest change. So that's why they are asking in the examination. Now, regional rural banks, that is 15% of ANBC. Advances to weaker section, 15%. For small finance banks, 12% only. Same manner, small finance banks and domestic commercial banks and foreign banks, no difference in advances to weaker section. So this slide is very, very important. At least 1 or 2 marks you will get from all examinations. At least 1 or 2 marks you will score if you can know. So this is as per latest circular updated. Now, from financial year 21-22 onwards, 2021-22 onwards, now they are giving a higher weight would be assigned to the incremental priority sector credit in identified districts of 184. RBI has identified 184 districts. Any incremental priority sector credit is there, they are giving a weight of 125%. What is the criteria? In that 184 districts, the per capita priority sector lending is less than 6,000. Per capita priority sector lending is less than 6,000 rupees in 184 districts. In the districts, any incremental priority sector credit is there, the banks will get a higher weightage of 125%. This is one latest change. Second point, a lower weight, 90%, any incremental priority sector credit in 205 districts. Here, comparatively, in these 205 districts, per capita priority sector lending is more than 25,000 rupees. So here, the priority sector credit is more in these districts. That's why we are getting a lesser weight on the incremental priority sector. Remaining districts, remaining all other districts, 100%. Now, totally from this slide, in per capita priority sector lending less than 6,000 rupees, 184 districts, you will get a higher weight of 125. And 205 districts, where priority sector lending is 25,000 rupees and above, you will get a lower weight of 90%. Remaining districts, any incremental credit, you will get 100%. This question was also asked in various examinations. And this is going to be reviewed by RBI in 2023-24. Now, description of eligible categories under priority sector. What are the advances? What are the eligible categories under priority sector? One by one, we are going to discuss. Now, this agriculture is one of the categories eligible for priority sector. Agriculture includes agriculture, allied activities, lending for agriculture infrastructure also. Now, loan against pledge, hypothecation of agriculture produce, including warehouse receipts for a period not exceeding 12 months. Loan up to 75 lakhs. Against national warehouse receipts. This is the latest amendment, 7th April 21. Loan against national warehouse receipts, NWR, or electronic negotiable warehouse receipts are there, ENWR. Bank can give loan up to 75 lakhs for a period of 12 months. And in other cases, 50 lakhs, in other cases where receipts other than NWR, means negotiable, other than negotiable warehouse receipts, other than electronic negotiable warehouse receipts, banks are allowed to give 50 lakhs under priority sector. If it is negotiable warehouse and electronic negotiable warehouse, 75 lakhs. This is the latest change. In the coming examinations, chance is there for getting questions. Farm credit to corporate farmers, 2 crores. This is the old one, no change. Farm credit to corporate farmers, 2 crores. Farmer producer organizations, farmer producers cooperatives, banks can leave loan up to 5 crores for entity under priority sector. Agriculture infrastructure will be aggregate sanction limit, 100 crores per borrower from the banking system. Agriculture infrastructure, all banks can give loan up to 100 crores per borrower. It will come under from the priority sector under agriculture. Ancillary services. Under agriculture ancillary services, banks are allowed to give loan to 50 crores to startup companies. Now, this is also latest and revised change. Under agriculture ancillary services, banks can give loan up to 50 crores to startup companies under agriculture priority sector. And loan to food and agro processing units, 100 crores for borrower from the banking system. So these ancillary service loans to up to 50 crores to startup companies comes under priority sector agriculture. Food and agro processing, 100 crores for borrower from the banking system. So startup, loan to startup, that is the recent introduction as per RBI guidelines. Small and marginal farmers, whatever the loans banks are giving, loan to small farmers means land holding up to 2 hectares, Marginal farmer means up to 1 hectare, it will come under agriculture. Lending by banks to NBFCs. Banks are lending to NBFCs and microfinance institutions for onward lending to agriculture up to 10 lakhs per borrower comes under priority sector. This is also one more additional avenue available to banks. Banks are giving loan to NBFCs and microfinance institutions. These institutions again onward lending to agriculture activities per borrower up to 10 lakhs comes under priority sector. Micro, small and medium enterprise. What are the loans? Whatever the loans we are giving, that MSME, that comes under priority sector. Whatever the loans we are giving under factoring transactions also comes under MSME. Factoring transactions pertaining to MSME taking place through trade receivables discounting system. So, factoring transactions routing through trade receivables discounting system also comes under priority sector MSME. This trade receivable discounting system is also very, very important. Loan to registered NBFCs, bank lending to registered NBFCs, and these NBFCs are onward lending to micro and small enterprises for borrower loan up to 20 lakhs will come priority sector. This is also there. Loan to registered non-banking financial. Registered means registration with RBI. On lending to micro small enterprises per borrower up to 20 lakhs comes under this. This is second one. Third one, description of eligible categories under priority sector. Third category, export credit. This condition is not applicable to RRBs and local area banks. Export credit under agriculture comes under priority sector. Export credit under MSME comes under MSME priority sector. That is there. In addition to that, export credit other than agriculture and MSC will be allowed to be classified as priority sector. As incremental credit, the export target for the banks, incremental export credit over corresponding data of the preceding year up to 2% of NBC or CEOBE, whichever is higher, and subject to a sanction limit of loan to a single borrower not exceeding 40 crores. So, export credit subject to a sanction limit of single borrower, 40 crores per borrower comes under priority sector. What is the target? Incremental credit, export credit over corresponding date of the preceding year up to 2%, that is the target for this. This question also very repeatedly it is coming. This is question number 3. Question description of eligible securities under priority sector. Fourth sector is education. Loan to individuals for education purpose up to 20 lakhs comes under priority sector. Education loan up to 20 lakhs for individuals for education including vocational, 20 lakhs comes under priority sector. Fourth category. Now fifth category, this is housing sector. Housing sector, metro. Banks are financing in metro means where population is more than 10 lakhs. Loan up to 35 lakhs, banks are allowed to finance, but cost of the housing project not exceeding 45 lakhs. So, metro housing loan, housing purpose loan, they can give 35 lakhs, but cost of the project of house not exceeding 45 lakhs. That is in metro. Other places, 25 lakhs and cost not exceeding 30 lakhs. Metro 35 lakhs, cost not exceeding 45 lakhs. Other places, loan up to 25 lakhs, housing project cost not exceeding 30 lakhs will come under priority sector. Repairs, housing loan, housing repairs. In metro, banks are allowed to give up to 10 lakhs under priority sector. In other places, 6 lakhs. Repairs, housing loan, housing sector repairs, loan up to 10 lakhs in metro areas and 6 lakhs in other areas, it will come under priority sector. Now, bank loans to any governmental agency. Bank loan to any governmental agency for construction of dwelling units or some slum clearance and rehabilitation of slum dwellers subject to dwelling unit carpet area not more than 60 square meters. So, this is a guideline that whenever banks are giving a loan to government agency for some clearance development, that the carpet area of the each construction unit not more than 60 square meters. Now bank loan for affordable housing projects under Government of India scheme, bank loans for affordable housing projects using at least 50% of floor area ratio, FAR, floor area ratio, or floor space index for dwelling units not more than 60 square meters. Bank loans for affordable housing projects using in that project at least 50% of floor area ratio or floor space index, they have to use for dwelling units, and the dwelling unit carpet area not exceeding 60 square meters. This question also they are asking frequently in these examinations. Housing, all overall housing loan is important. Social sixth category, description of eligible categories under priority sector. So sixth category, social infrastructure. Bank loans up to 5 crores for borrower for setting up of schools, drinking water facilities, sanitation facilities, it will come under priority sector up to 5 crores. And recent amendment, recent change, loans up to 10 crores for borrower, loans up to 10 crores for borrower for building up healthcare facilities under Ayushman Bharat central government scheme. So under this Ayushman Bharat central government scheme, banks are allowed to give a single loan 10 crores for borrower, but the criteria is the cities are tier 2 to tier 6 centers. Tier 2 to tier 6 center means population is less than 1 lakh. Tier 2 means population less than 1 lakh area. So this is about social infra 5 crores, 10 crores for Ayushman Bharat healthcare facility. This is about social infrastructure, sixth category. Seventh category, renewable energy. Banks loan up to 30 crores for borrower, banks are allowed to give for renewable energy. These are the facilities: solar based power generator, biomass based power generator, windmills, micro hydel plants, and for non conventional. Now sometimes in the examination they are asking, under renewable energy for what facilities banks are allowed, means the student, the participant must aware of the solar based power generations, biomass based power generations, windmills, micro hydel projects, and non conventional energy based public utilities, street lighting, all the you have to know. That's why we are providing all the material also. And for individual household we can give 10 lakhs. Same manner, social infra means what are the facilities will cover under social infra means you have to know all these things. Seventh is over. Now eighth, miscellaneous. Eighth, others. Description of eligible categories under priority sector, other categories. Others, loan not exceeding 1 lakh for borrower, 1 lakh for borrower, provided directly by banks to individuals and individual members of self-help groups, joint lending groups, provided their income not exceeding 1 lakh in rural areas, other areas 1 lakh 60. So their income not exceeding 1 lakh in rural, other areas 1.6 lakhs, banks are allowed to give directly 1 lakh to borrower, even self-help group, joint lending group members directly, that is there. And loan to distressed persons, loan to distressed person other than distressed farmers, loan to distressed persons, banks are allowed to give loan up to 1 lakh for prepayment of their loan to non-institutional investors. Here distressed person means not covered under distressed farmers. So banks are allowed to give loan up to 1 lakh under priority sector for prepayment of their loan to non-institutional lender. This is also earlier this is a change. And third point, loans to 50 crores to startup companies. Now they are using frequently startup companies. All participants, members, they must aware of the definition given by MSME under MSME for startup. What is the definition for startup? Turnover should be less than 100 crores in any previous financial year. So, once a unit is called as startup means turnover not exceeding 100 crores in any previous financial year. And an entity shall be considered as a startup up to 10 years from the date of its incorporation. From the date of its incorporation, registration up to 10 years as a startup company, number one. Number two, during these 10 years, first year to 10 years, turnover should not exceed 100 crores in any of the financial year. Then, if the unit is fulfilling these two conditions, that unit is called as startup companies. Startup companies. This is it. Weaker sections. Weaker section advances also comes under priority sector. Small and marginal farmers. Small means 2 hectares. Holding marginal farmer means 1 hectare. Whatever the loans giving under, beneficiaries means borrowers under NRLM, National Rural Livelihood Mission, National Urban Livelihood Mission, SC, ST category borrowers, DRI, Differential Rate of Interest, Self-Help Groups, Persons with Disability, all will come. Minority communities, Sikhs, Muslims, Christians, Zoroastrians, Buddhists and Jains. Sometimes they are asking one question, what is the, who are the minority communities? Or which one of the following not belong to minority community? So, the participant must aware of what are the communities comes under minority. Minority community, the six Muslims, Christians, Zoroastrians, Buddhists and Jains. So, all these six communities comes under minority. This is as per RBI circular. Overdraft facility in PM, Pradhan Mantri Janadhan Yojana accounts. Normally, banks are giving loan up to 10 lakh.